challenge made on Ravelry. Sprite966 everywhere else. Instagram. Basically Instagram, Ravelry. With a wand made. That's the only two places I go in. Yeah, anyway. Homage to the bunny. Flying by the seat of my pants today, thought I better get an episode out. So I've been doing this for nearly a year, and this is episode 14, because I'm just lazy. Sorry people, I love you so much, but I'm so lazy. I'm so enjoying my new peace and quiet, so to speak. I'm also enjoying getting back into my knitting. A wee bit of spinning, I've not brought that in because it's just a spindle. Got a wee bit to show you, but got a new TV this month. As you know, my work's shutting down, and the shop model, if it was on display, he was taking 25% off. So I got a £200 telly for £150. And it'll do me nicely. It's a 39 inch. Oh, excuse me, juice. So I've got a wee bit to show you, a wee bits of the pieces that I've been up to. That's why I'm sticking them on the arm of the chair. They're just the pound ones, they're not my expensive ones. As you know, I was knitting on charity socks for the Catholic missionaries in Chicago. So I've got two socks, the Laura Linneman Afterthought heel socks. I know there's big boo hoo about whether it's Afterthought or Forethought or whatever, because you put the lifeline in for the heel to start with. I had plenty of yarn left because she's only got wee teeth, tiny, tiny feet. She's a size 7, which is like 4.5 here. So and it mits to match, because it's going to be cold. They're a wee bit tight, snug on me, but I've got a bigger hand than a wee tiny person. So she's get a matching set. If I'd had enough, I'd have done a hat, but I might have enough for a square. So yes, there is two. And they just get the hole for the thumb. Nothing spectacular, just to keep your handies warm on a cold winter night. So that's them. I just need to get them soaked or bathed and then get them sent off to Sock Bunny. Also, I've not got the mitts. I don't know, I think they might be in my work actually, because I've been wearing them in my work because of reason. I did this for because it's pinkish. And I didn't get it up in Kathy or Denise's group for the knit along, but it's not as much about getting the prizes, it's just knitting along. And even though I don't talk or type in the groups, I still enjoyed knitting the hat and getting it finished for the 31st of October. So I've got the barley hat, what's the mitts called? Maize. And this month they're doing socks and the perfect, no, Yoss, year of Stash socks. Is it Stash socks? It's the Yoss group anyway, it's Tammy and Adrian and Krista. Ginger, is it? Is it the four of them? Oh, I'm not sure anyway, but anyway, so, and they're doing the rye socks, so I've got my yarn, I'll show you that in a minute for what I'm going to be doing next. So that's my barley. I made it a wee bit slouchy at the back. Oh, this is beautiful yarn that's up. I won this yarn on a prize a wee back in the day, and it's the Flamboyance, and it's a DK But, oh, God, I don't know what the... I've not got the tag. Can't find the tag. Maybe it's on my project. You know, on my stash page. What the... What's... But, oh, it's lovely. I would get it again. The only thing is, when you're knitting with it, it's hairy. And you end up with these wee baubles, you know, sliding along. And you've got to pick them off every so often. Oh, I don't like that bit. But, look at the hair. I really need to sort this hair. It's driving me crazy. Anywho. I'm wondering if this is going to be talking at the same speed. Looks like there's a wee delay. But anyway, so that's my hat in the midst of match. So what have I been knitting on? I have been knitting on socks. In my silver pumpkin, isn't it? No, silver pumpkin bag. But I don't think she makes bags anymore. I like this one because it's got the wee handles and it's also got a drawstring. So I had done one sock ages ago in the Peyton's Croy. Nutty Frog, because it was far too wee. I don't know what I was thinking about. So I frogged it and started the second sock. And this is like, as far as I know, it's much healthier. So anyway, and this is in the Peyton's Croy, and this is in the brown marl. I don't need to put the eyes on. Blue brown marl. And they've got loads and loads of colours. I've got the blue rag as well, but I think they're coming out with loads and loads of colours. Well, in America they don't have it here. But it's a good kind of worky horse one, but it's quite... I don't think I could wear it next to my neck right enough, but on my feet. A bit jaggy. So, I've been working on my socks and there are my signatures. Still waiting on the ones coming for the UK. And I was right, she did eventually message me. And she said she was out of stock. And she had to wait for them coming. She was going to refund me, and I thought, well, what's the point? I want the needles, so I'll just wait. So she said about 10 days, so I think that was about maybe 10 days ago. I'll have to check my emails for that, but I definitely will not order from her again. Quite disappointed. It would work out actually £2 cheaper going straight to the site. And getting them shipped, and that's paying the UK customs. It's not so much the customs, it's the handling charge. Because you're only, if you're over a certain amount of money, I don't know what it is, I think it's 36 for a gift, 15 for if you're paying for something. But if you're over a certain amount of money, then the UK tax you. So the tax is like £3 something, which I'm like, well, that's fine because. You know, greedy tax man, he's got to make his money somehow. But then they charge you £8 handling. Well, they're handling it anyway. So they're charging you £8 to turn around and tell you that you need to pay an extra £3. That gets me. It's the £8 handling charge that annoys me. And that's why a lot of people are only shipping from America. Or they're now stopping and thinking, well, we need to really stick to the UK or Europe. Which is a sin because a load of the stuff that I like comes to the US. It will stop me buying. If I want something, I will pay the stupid handling charge. But that's because you want the item anyway. And okay, I think the UK is starting to come out with more cell stripers and more hangman. But you like what you like, you know what I mean? It's not like, you just like what you like, so anyway, that's that. And what else have I been knitting on? I've been knitting on my driftwood. Hurrah! So, yep, I'm in the round. Hold on. And I'm doing this in the... what's it's done in this yarn? It's the Cascade Yarns 220 Superwash. Because I done it in the Cascade 220. Dark and Stormy. I won that in the first podcast that I ever washed nipples. I won a pattern in her group and I picked Dark and Stormy. And I knit it in a beautiful kind of chocolatey brown. And I did all that eyes. Cascade again, because I know how to wash, but it's sometimes it's just a pain being that careful. So anyway, isn't that lovely? So I'm quite happy that's coming on, and that's what I've been knitting on. I haven't really been knitting on anything else. No, I've not. Watching loads of podcasts again. In fact, yesterday I watched most of James and hi James, Dancing Geek that is. I watched most of James and then he kept telling me about things. I had to go and look, and he's such an enabler, James. And then he was talking about a podcast and I had to stop his podcast to go and see what he was talking about in that podcast. And then my heart went out to the last, because I went through the same thing a long time ago. So. Totally, I wished I had to find out. I was like, so anyway, that's beside the point. So, because I got my new TV and it's, I'll thing with the camera and later on show you my new TV before I switch off. And Mayhem, I'm there right in the middle. And then I watched Motive after it on Universal, and that's what I sat and done up to, well, about half six, seven, and then I went to bed and read for it. But that was me, about 4 hours worth of, because it was about 4 episodes, 2 Law and Order and 2 Motive. So it was quite enjoyable, because picture was kind of big, seeing them going, not blind, but the sights going through now. So anyway, I did have stash enhancement, and it came, I showed you the stuff that I got. Well, I'd ordered this at the same time, but this came after I had recorded. So I'll show you. Oh, I can show you this. Navi Sama. I love that guy. Look. Is it that beautiful? Beautiful! He's got a wee bit of colours, hasn't he? I've been after one of them for years, and I just thought to myself, oh, you're hooking it. Just get yourself one. Look at this hair, man. Aimed a hairdresser out there. Anyway, so now, I bought the pattern. Oh, I bought it. I'm still waiting for a couple of things to come. I'm still waiting for my Ravelry sweatshirt, and I'm still waiting for my Highland Handmaids. Because I got two. I got the multicoloured one for Fru, and the orange. Now, the orange is to make a shawl. It's the Guardian of Air shawl by Amy B. Hudson Valley Knits. So I needed another colour. It's two colour. It's a two colour shawl. It's absolutely beautiful. And proceeds were for the yarn, for Heather, and the yarn, and the pattern. That both so much was going to sell through Wendy, and she's home, and it was that lovely to see her home and happy, and still going through it, but. So strong, Wendy. Love you. So anyway, so I can get this, I want to knit this shawl, and it's a knit along she's doing as well, and I don't know, I mean, I might never get it finished in time, but that's not the point, it's what you do the shawl anyway. So you can use a podcaster's yarn, podcaster's pattern, and the mere things to do with podcasters, the mere entries you get, so I think, by the time I'm finished, I'll get three entries. But anyway, that's if I get it done in time. Anyway, so I was like, oh, what colours can I get? And I thought, I love that orange. But what yarn can I get to go with it? And it's, you know, I was looking at the yardage, and I thought, well, if I go another skein, I would need to get a skein in a bit. And I thought, nah. And then I remembered Leading Men Fibre Arts. Now, I bought fibre for him, for Steve, and away at the beginning when he first started, again because of the postage, and I thought, oh, I need to get it, I've seen it for ages, and Jenna for Retro Lemon, she knit with this colour, I don't know if it was this yarn, but it was this colour, and it's called Dirty Truth. How beautiful is that? Oh, greens again. And it's the soliloquy. I'm trying to see, the eyes are away. Soliloquy or soliloquy. And it's the Dirty Truth colourway. I'll take this up, see if it comes up. So, and that's Steve and Andy. And that was one again, unfortunately, that had the handle in charge. I don't care who's part of that. So anyway, so I got that. So when the orange comes, and I'll download the pattern, and I can show you what it's got built. It's just going to look... Oh. So anyway, so I got that. Put that. And my newbie. There. So anyway, another yarn, because this is, I was saying to you that I was on looking for like UK, and I was putting UK. This is one of the new podcasts I talked about earlier. So anyway, right on, I was looking, and this one popped up. I thought, oh, I love the colours. So I'm going to call this. And it doesn't matter what pattern I get, but I'm going to call this From Russia With Love. It's from St. Petersburg in Russia. And it's called Wool Silk Lace. I'm sure that's the name of the shop. It's on Etsy. Wool Silk Lace. Rushkies, and that's the name. called Royal of the Hand Dyed Silk Striping Sock Yarn. It was $8 shipping and $18 for the. I just love that it's in Russia, I'll never get rid of that. So that was great. Look at the colours. And you know that's shown up. Maybe not just as bright. But oh aye, that's it. Look at the colours. The purple's a wee bit more purple. So this here is a wee bit more like a royal purple. No, it's still a wee bit purplier rather than the blue here. But oh, and it's so soft. And it smells nice as well. James likes the smell. So anyway, so that's from Wool Silk Lace on Etsy. In Russia. So whatever I'm going to knit, socks or whatever, they're just going to be called From Russia With Love. And I think I will get more when I save some pennies. Maybe for my birthday I'll get another one for Russia. There was stuff for Germany. Stuff for Russia. Stuff for America. I need to get some hedgehog fibres because they're from Ireland. I've not had any for Ireland. So that'd be quite good and they get loads of stuff. So anyway, James is an enabler. Showing off counts of ways. Fibre. So yes, I did. I went on. And I thought, ah, why not? Know that I'll, you know, I've got a wee joke of fight, but I've got to, excuse me for crinkling, but. Oh, it's so soft. Oh. And this is the 12 Caesars collection. And this is called Very Well, I Will Adopt the Surname Concordia. Of course it's green, a bit of teal, a wee bit of kind of orangey yellow. Oh, how nice is that? Look, it matches. So, that's how it's always. One, I should have told you what the fibre was in this one. That's 100% Blue Face Leicester. So it doesn't look good. I know, I'm bad. But makes me colour. No, this one's called Attack, and it's a superwash merino. No, it's coming at me a blue again. It's purple. It's bright purple and red and kind of navy. And, oh. Beautiful. So as I was saying about my sock kit up, socks that I'm going to be knitting. Oh, I should be putting that off. So, I'm going to be knitting socks. was like, what? Because they're done in a, like, a, like between a double knit and a worsted. I think so, anyway. I'm sure it's a worsted, but I thought double knitting would probably do. Now, this is saying it's a four ply, and I'm thinking, not in your nellies, that's a four ply, it's more a double knitting. And this was given to me. Does it say it's a four ply? Aye, sock yarn. And I don't know if these people exist anymore. Created with fibre.co.uk. And they're saying this is a sock yarn, but it's quite thick for a. Maybe it's just a heavy fingering. But anyway, I think I'm just going to do the dye with these. What do you think, James? Maybe you can come up and do me a brownie in a mug. As long as you bring the herdy mug. So, I was thinking I'd do a name and that. But I'll maybe do a swatch. I never swatch. But I might do a swatch to see. I thought they'd be quite nice. House socks. So, that's all my knitting goodness, I think. I don't think there's anything else to tell you. I've got some DVDs, but nothing spectacular. As I say, the course shutting, so they're reducing 75 in quite a lot of things. So things that were full price are now doing to, like, some of the DVDs, if they were £4, they're now doing it to £2, so some of them are half price. I got a hot water bottle. Well, I got two for 75p each. I've got some books put by. Other bits and pieces, as I say, I've got my TV. So that's no yarn purchases, but I'm glad I've got yarn still to come. And then, as I say, 3-4 weeks and we're finished anyway. But I think I'm going to just take Christmas off anyway. Because most places I've got all their Christmas temps. Most places are too far away. So I'll see. I'll need to have a look and think and see what I want to do next year. So that's me. Oh, I done some of my blankets. I done another two. So I've got, did I say, 9 altogether now? But I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 with all the endies to sew on, so I need to get them done. And I've run out of wool, so I need to wait till next month and order some more Lion Brand. Vanna's Choice. I'm knitting this in Vanna's Choice. So, yes. It's a brown and a burgundy, but it looked it was both the same colour there, didn't it? In the back. But it's a brown and a kind of burgundy, see? But anyway. So that'll cut the other now. Aye, so that's me. Got a few things I need to get organised for postage. That might need to wait to get my next pay because of the telly. I wasn't messing that bargain like that. Oh, I've got to show you the telly, wasn't I? So, hopefully, you'll not be sick. That's the fireplace. Yo, hold on. I'm not very good with this. Had you. Sorry, I'm making you sick. Oh dear. 39 inch. There, you can see me sunning in the back. So that's not bad. This must have been a meal. You see? Right, anyway. Trying not to make you sick. clear. And I've only been to Weight Watchers for 2 weeks. Last week, I had to go and wait for my daughter's internet to get in. And I was only losing an hour for work, whereas they would have lost like lost half a day and things like that. And I thought, well, I'll go up. And so the time he came, that was way too late for me to go to Weight Watchers, so I never go up. And the week before, I was having a bad week. No, so much eating, but just didn't want to go, just wanted to stay in the house. So I just stayed in the house. And then I was up at court, a bit of excitement, as a witness for the defence. The case is still going on, so I can't talk about it. But I don't know if my testimony done any help, but hopefully a wee bit. So that's it. That was my excitement for 2 days, and we're just sitting there, it was just me and another girl. It was just like, ever going to take us? So we get told on the first day at the back of two that we're only going to get taken, and then this is come back for 10 o'clock. And Friday morning comes, Thursday night she phones and says, oh, don't come up till about 11 now, there's no way you'll be seen before 11. So we get up there and we're waiting, nah. Half past 12 she comes and says, no, you'll not get seen till nearly 2. Away you go, so it's in Glasgow, so we're away and went into TD Hughes and had a wee look round and see bags. I was like, oh, if I only had mere money. So I had a bit of window shopping, and then we went into this wee, what's it called, a central calf? And me and the lass had chips and salad, and her mother, who was up with her, she had a mini fish supper. So that was lovely. And it was, as what the lass was saying, it's amazing if you put salad out to yourself, you're like, it's alright. But somebody else puts salad out to you, and it tastes delicious. What's that all about? Craziness. So, we get back there for 2. She gets seen at 20 to 4, and I get seen at 5 to 4. But my testimony was very, very quick. I was in and out in 5 minutes, I think. But if I could have done a wee bit of help then, that would be good. I've got my blinds still to put up, but I need a hacksaw to cut them to size. Probably sit and watch the rest of my podcast, which is House of Knitting. I'm on episode 3. This is the first time I've seen her. I've just joined a Ravelry group, so go over. She's Salem and North Carolina, I think. Seems quite good so far. She's doing a knit along, but I'm not really got good with knit alongs. I try, but maybe do James's one. James is going to find out more, because I think it's a hat. I think that's what he said. And I watched Laura's podcast at the corner of Knit and Tea. And I'm waiting for my girls, Kinnison, hiya, waiting for them to upload theirs. But sometimes I don't catch that till Monday morning. Depends on how late it gets uploaded. Sometimes I'll leave it deliberately to the Monday, because it's that nice. Especially if I'm not working in the morning, just get up and sit with my girls. I haven't watched Kathy's last one. Or Nick Nickaroni. I really makeup was brilliant, by the way. Your makeup was fantastic. I loved it, Nikki. Try to think of anything else. Got my Christmas card swap partner, and he messaged her back. Got a Christmas in the Ravelry chatter group. I'm sure it's just a card we've designed. I don't think we've designed anything else. Better not be, because what I've got to send is all I'll be sending this year. I'm sure it's just a card. Still never showed you my mug. Show you the one I got for. I've not sent it yet. Anyway, just in case you're watching, Grace, this is the mug. I'm going to wrap it in bubble wrap, put it in there, and I'm going to wrap the box in bubble wrap because it's going to Canada. And somebody sent one, Denise in England one, and that's Denise in Ittenden. And it got there fine. I should have asked her how she wrapped it, or how the person had wrapped it. Anyway, this is the Glasgow mug. This is what's coming your way, Juniper Grace. Do I break it? So, and that's the armadillo. That's it, next to the SECC. That's Squinty Bridge. No, that's the fourth road. No, that's going to be Squinty Bridge. And that's a crane. It's a big crane. It's one of Glasgow's highlights in the shipbuilding. So that's a Glasgow mug, so that's exactly what my mug looks like. So there's a couple other wee things in there for you, but you'll see them when they come. You know what a mug looks like, so. That's to come. That's to get posted. Things to do, places to go, people to see. I think that's about me. Apart from being up to Glasgow at co-work. Doing ironing. Oh, I'm still reading the Knitter's Mystery. I'm in Patterns in the Sand. I'm going to finish this. And I'm totally a blank. I just can't work out who's done it. But I'm getting a real affinity with the characters. I'm really enjoying it. So I've got the next book. So I need to go looking what the next book is after that and get it ordered. Hi, so that's me. I think I'll leave you at that. That's long enough, but oh, I love this. So, I'll maybe wait till I get my next pay before I send you the money, Navi, and send you a wee something, something. A wee Scottish something, something. How lovely is that? I mean, that would just cheer you up in any dull day. So, anyway, I'm going to go, people. So, I want to say hello to everybody. Again, I thank you for joining the YouTubes, and if you're in the Ravelry group and playing the word game, go for it. So I think I'm going to do an at-along from now till Christmas, and I'll pick the winner after Christmas, and I'll date up to the 31st. December, so you get something new in the new year and you get something nice to come. And what it'll be is like a Christmas gift. If you're knitting a Christmas gift for anybody. And it can be a double, triple, mega flipper dipper. See if we can get some life in my group. Don't know what the prize will be. Could be anything. Might not be to do with knitting. something, something. It might be a pattern. Who knows? Unless you're a detective and you're inside this mess that's in here. Because somewhere in there, there'll be a decision made of what the prize will be. And unless you're a detective and have loads of little grey cells, good chance. But anyway, so yes, I think that's what we'll do. We'll do a cal, crochet, knit, along. So it could be a kcal, aye, that's what I'll put it in, a kcal, knit, crochet, along. So it's a kcal. There we go, made up a new word. Because it's, you kind of put in cal/cal, I can just put in a kcal. Helen's got a kcal in her group. So anyway, if you want to join, come on over to... What's the group called? I use Sprite966 podcast. What's it, Nat's podcast? Just look for Orange Maiden. See where I'm a moderator. I'm only a moderator in one place. I'm sure it's Sprite. In fact, hold on and I'll tell you. Oh, let it go out. Stupid person. Right, hold on, peoples. I think I've got the link on my page anyway. Ravelry Burb. Aye, Sprite966 podcast, that's one. So I'll go and put that in, because we've got 166 members in there, right, people? Who's the last lot to join? 16 days ago, we'll start there. Because I need to do, I've probably not done it for ages, so a couple of months anyway. I do my random pattern person, just send a person a pattern a day, a download, and then a random number. So I might just do that today and send out to some random person. So if you get a message, it'll be a pattern. So I might actually pick the pattern. No, I might let you pick the pattern. We'll see. Surprise, surprise, surprise. So anyway, 16 days ago, Sarah S.E. Hepworth is, I'm sure it's Sarah. Hold on. Yeah, Sarah from Bradford. And then we've got Little Yellow Luke, and that's Zena from Sutton Coldfield. Then, hi Zena. And then we've got Kat from South Carolina. Hi Kat, that's Knit Pearl Girl. It's not Knit Pearl Girl. It's Knit Up Girl. And then we've got 11 days ago, and 11 days ago we've got Soy Latte. Is that right? Kay, is that right? Soy Latte. Tell me if I'm wrong. And she's from Bendigo in Victoria, Australia. Then we've got 5 days ago, GD Penguin, Tina from Port Orchard. Where's Port Orchard, Tina? And then 3 days ago, we've got Loa Ann, L-O-A-A-L-O-W-A-A-N-N-E, Loa Ann. And she's Laurie from Brooktondale, NY, so that's New York, I think. So, welcome, welcome, welcome. And I've been perusing through, the, you know, recently shared projects. And there's some, that hat's amazing. Who was it done that hat? You really need to go in and have a wee look, peeps. Yarn Yacker. Now, so who are you? Did you join not that long ago either? She done the Hanford cap. She's Janie and she's from New Brunswick in Canada. So hi. She done this lovely hat. It's like a stockinette cap. We have a big rib. And then there's a wee, I don't know what's that on the end. Is it a cross? Or a ghost or something? It's really lovely. So, go and have a look at Yarn Yacker's pattern. Hanford cap. Seasonal stocking cap. It's very nice. And then my new podcast is, and she's Kirsten Holmes on YouTube. It's a housewarming cal she's doing. And I think all you need to do is do a post in her thread, like a beginner post, and then blather away. But I'm not very good at the blathering, so that might not be very good for me. So, but I've got loads of podcasts to catch up on. I've even got the last one, Denise's last week's one. I've not caught up with that yet. They just keep popping up, and you're like, I can't keep up with this. And then, excuse me, if I watch normal TV, I miss podcasts. And then if I watch my podcast, I miss some things on TV. But I don't really mind missing TV, to be honest. But that's me. Enough. I'm going to go. Yes, I'm going to go random generate. And I kind of do it on... I need to do it on my tablet. Because I don't have Office on my anyway. And when you download, you need Office. And I've got Polar Office on my tablet. And I was only paying £30 just to get Office, which I don't really need. So... then I managed to get something. I don't know how I did that. I managed to get something. Lost the plot. Right. Anyway, until next time. I don't know if it'll be a week or a fortnight. Or 10 days. It's never really the same day as... you never know when I'm going to pop up. I'm like your Pimpernel. The secret here, the secret there. Anyway. So that's me. I'm off to do some perusing. My mum wants some books. The Regency collection has some new books. She's got most of them. So, Silken Scandal. When that's high society affairs. I'm made into murder and mystery. But anyway, until next time, peeps. And look out for the Not Long. Come on, join in. As I say, it's not a great big talking group, but play a board game. Post some pickies. Tell us what you're not knowing. Because I know there's not many groups, but as I say, it doesn't have to be something just special for my cow. It could be a hat, a sweater. There is no... I mean... I know some people say it's unfair if somebody's knitting like a sweater and somebody's knitting a hat, but there's no rules in this one. So if you're already knitting it, as long as it's starting this month in November, so basically from the 1st of November to the 31st of December, so 2 months, and most people are doing like 2 months knit alongs in anyway, because people are knitting for Christmas, they're not wanting any pressure, so it could be a No, an ornament, they're too wee. I mean, unless you do 10 ornaments, you put them in as one project. Hat and mitts, babies, whatever you want. That's what we'll call it, whatever you want. Kcal. Right, that's me, I'm off skin. I'm rambling now. I'm going to go and pick a winner. Watch out, people, it could be you.